Ephesians chapter 1, reading from verse number 3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ, according as he has chosen us in him from the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he had made us accepted in the beloved, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sin, according to the riches of his grace, wherein he had abound towards us all wisdom and prudence, having made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he had proposed in himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of time he might gather together in all one of all things in Christ, both that which is in heaven and that which is on earth, even in him, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestinated according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will. And the church shout, amen. Hallelujah. In whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestinated according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his will. He predestinates us to walk after the counsel of his will. May the counsel of God's will direct your life. Prophetic destiny. What is the prophetic? The prophetic is an advanced knowledge of what God wants to do, what God is doing, and what God will do, and what God wants to do in any life, family, city, nation, church, or an individual. An advanced knowledge, the word of God carries that advanced knowledge, that any man that encounters God's word seem to have an advanced knowledge of what God has ordained for him. Jeremiah 1 verse 5, and the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. But verse 5, the Bible says, before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before thou comest forth out of the womb, I sanctified thee and ordained thee a prophet unto the nation. Jeremiah had not yet been born, but God said, before he was formed in the belly, God had given him a divine destiny. Only the word of God delivered that destiny to him. Only the word of God did what? Delivered the destiny to him. Without the word of God, Jeremiah will live an ordinary life. Unknown to him is a prophet of a timeless generation. Today, I am speaking out of the book of the prophet of Jeremiah. He has crossed time. He has crossed generation. Give God a hand of praise. He will have lived an ordinary life. Who will have believed that he will be quoted here in Nigeria? But that's how God is, and that who God is. In Genesis chapter 12, verse 1, the same word of God came unto Abraham. Get thee out of thy country and from thy kindred and from thy father's house unto the land that I will show thee. And I will make thee a great nation, and I will bless thee, and I will make thee great, and thou shalt be a blessing. At this age of his life, nothing significant was in his life, nothing great was mentioned, but God's word came and began to say these things. Verse 3, I will bless them that bless thee, and curse them that curse thee. And indeed shall all the family of the earth be blessed. How dare you say you have no prophetic destiny? If Abraham today is significant, that you and I can claim his blessing as ours, he lived a prophetic destiny. You are getting your prophetic destiny. He was an ordinary man. But look at Verse 4. So Abraham departed as the Lord has spoken to him. Some of us are not moving as God speaks. Some of us are waiting for ourselves, for waiting for circumstance, waiting for the society, waiting for news to tell you what to do. And Abraham departed as the Lord has spoken unto him. And Lot went with him. Abraham was 75 years old when he departed from Haran. A man was 75 years old when he found his destiny. When he came to discover that he had a prophetic destiny. God's word delivers the future of your tomorrow. God's word is the key of your generation. Thank God for your hard work. Thank God for so many things going on in your life. Thank God for your education. But hear me, to fulfill destiny, it's a prophetic grace. Thank God for your connection and contact, but none of them can do what God's word can do. It moved at 75 years by the word of God. By the word of God. In this same Genesis chapter 13 verse 2, he became rich in silver and gold, and many things came into his life because he obeyed the word of God. Because he obeyed the word of God. Genesis 13, verse number 2. He became rich in silver. He became rich in gold. He became rich in cattle. He was prospering, not just because he wanted, but because the word of God has given him his destiny. Can I hear a shout of amen? That's why the Bible says in the book of Jeremiah, chapter 29, verse 11, God speaking to his children says, he says, I know the thought that I have. For I know the thoughts that I think towards you, saith the Lord, thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. To give you an expected end. A end that your friends cannot predict. Can I hear you lift your voice and shout amen? An end that nobody can organize for you, but I'll do it. Look at the next verse. He says, glory to God. But what? To give an expected end. He says in verse 12, of this Jeremiah, after giving you an experience, and he said, then shall ye call upon me, and ye shall what? Go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you. Verse 13, glory to God, praise the Lord. He says, and ye shall seek me and find me when ye shall search for me with all your hearts. The word of God is the center of our destiny. I know the thoughts I have towards you. You think your life will go the way the economy is going? Your life will go the way everything is looking like? No. The word of God is the key to take you out of every limitation and take you to God's abundance. When Jacob was to leave the earth, after he found his son, Joseph, with a prophetic destiny, who had a dream, and by his prophetic dream, God moved his life, took him out of a lot of obstacles. Before Jacob died, he called the entire children in the book of Genesis chapter 49, verse 1. He said to the children, Genesis 49, verse 1, he gathered them together. He said, and Jacob called his sons and said, gather yourself together, that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the days. In the last days, that I will tell you what will happen in your future. I want to prophesy. Jacob carried the prophetic mandate of grace. He got it from his father. His father spoke upon his life, and he saw it come to pass. And now he gathered the entire sons of Israel to speak into their life, to speak into their destiny. He said, this is what will happen to you in the days to come. Verse 2, he began to say with them, he says, gather yourselves together and hear, ye sons of Jacob, and hearken unto Israel your father. There's somebody hearing my voice. Your destiny is about to turn to a dimension of glory. I didn't hear your amen. I didn't hear your amen. Every time the children of Israel got to the point of being stranded, God will speak a word. Somebody hearing my voice today, I don't know what is happening to you. Your prophetic destiny is about to showcase what God has planned for your life. I thank God for you and I. We have a good plan for ourselves, but none of us have a better plan than God's word. Abraham had his own plan. He left and he began to follow God. And he was expecting. His mind was centered on his fruitfulness. He was centered on getting children. At the time, he discovered that it looked like as if it was not coming to pass. Genesis chapter 15, God appeared to him in verse 1. And he says, and after these things, the word of the Lord came unto Abraham in a vision, saying, fear not, Abraham. I am thy shield and thy exceedingly great reward. Lift up your voice. God is your shield. I declare, lift your hands. I say, God is your shield. What is a shield? A shield is a protection. A shield protects you from the arrows of the wicked, the bullets of the enemy. It also protects you from shame. It protects you from humiliation. It protects you from attack. It protects you from the satanic gang up and conspiracy. Somebody said, the Lord is my shield. He protects you. When everybody expects you to fall to the ground, he catches you. He said, I am your shield. Look at the next verse, verse 2. And Abraham said, Lord God, what will thou give me, seeing I go childless? The steward of my house is this Eliezer of Damascus. Now the Bible says, and Abraham said, behold, to me thou hast given no seed, but lo, one born in my house is my heir. Because his servant, his messenger, his slave, has had a son. And of course, by tradition, any child born in your house takes your inheritance. He said, Lord, does it mean I'm not going to have any child? Look at what you have blessed me, but it's my servant's son that will take it. And look at what the word of God said to him when he said, I am your exceedingly great reward. Can I hear an amen? Behold, the word of the Lord came. The word of the Lord came unto him, saying, this shall not be thy heir, but he that shall come forth out of thy own bowels shall be thy heir. Give God a hand. Listen to me. God cannot do it without saying it. He must say it before he do it. So I say to you right now, as you hear this word, God is already saying, as you leave this place, he will do what he said. I didn't hear your amen. Our prophetic destiny is tied to the word. The word we receive is the key to our future. And that is what we need to make our prophecy. Prophesy the word of God into your life. Declare God's word over your life. Declare it over your children. Declare it over your business. Declare it over your circumstance. Declare it into the womb of your tomorrow. Lift your voice and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I prophesy your word into the womb of my tomorrow. You are my exceedingly great reward. Can I hear you shout amen? You will reward me above the labors of my hands. You will open doors beyond what I see. Can I hear an amen? God said to Timothy, God was speaking to Timothy through Paul. Paul writing to Timothy in 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 18. He said to Timothy, Paul being a master of the word, knows what God's word will do. He said, behold, the word, and God began to speak clearly for Timothy to receive the experience, the grace that God has put in him and that God has stored in his life. He said to Timothy, he said, make war with that which, with the prophecies that has gone ahead unto thee. 1 Timothy chapter 1 verse 18. He said to him, this charge I commit into thee, son Timothy, according to the prophecies which went before on thee, that thou by them mightest war a good warfare. That by these prophecies, by the declarations that has been prophesied over you, what has been proclaimed upon you, that you make a good warfare with them, that you contend for your prophetic destiny. Timothy, don't allow your life go the way circumstances going. Don't allow your life go the way situation is taking you. Contend for your prophetic destiny. Make war, he says, according to the prophecy which went on before on thee. Somebody say, prophecies that has come upon my life. He said, by those prophecy, make your war. By those prophecy, stand. By those prophecy, fight the enemy. Contend with the wicked. Because, hear me, the wicked one must be stopped. Can I hear you shout amen? Prophecy gives you an advanced knowledge of what God is doing, of what God wants to do, of what God is about to do in the future or now. This advanced knowledge gives you an advantage against the wicked one. This advanced knowledge gives you grace ahead. When Jesus was born, there was an advanced knowledge. The wise men went, and God told the wise men, don't go back and meet Herod. And God told Joseph, take the child out from Bethlehem and take the child to Egypt. Come back when Herod dies. An advanced knowledge of what God has ordained for your life. And I see God bringing this advanced knowledge that you may make warfare. Because God will not say a thing and it will not come to pass. It is time to rise and contend for your prophetic destiny. I know the situation of the earth look like as if everything is a mirage. But your prophetic destiny must surely come to pass. For every word that has gone forth out of the mouth of God will not return unto him void until it has accomplished that which it is spoken for. David speaking in the scripture in the book of Psalm 13, verse 3. David said unto the Lord, enlighten my eyes, open my eyes, open my eyes. Consider and hear me, O Lord my God. Lighten my eyes, lest I sleep the sleep of death, lest I live a life of no result. I sleep the sleep of death. I live a life that there will be nothing to show, nothing to accomplish, nothing to get anything. Open my eyes, enlighten my eyes. He went further in verse 4. He said to him, glory to God, lest my enemies say I have prevailed against him, and those that trouble me rejoice when I am moved. Your enemies will not rejoice over you. Your prophetic destiny will counter their prophecies, their declarations, their plans, and all their conspiracy. He went further to say, glory to God, he said, but I have trusted in thy mercy, and my heart shall rejoice in thy salvation. Can I hear an amen? I will sing unto the Lord, because thou hast dealt bountifully with me. Lift your voice and say, oh Lord, thou hast dealt bountifully with me. When I think of the prophecies of God's word, David said at a time in the scripture, he said, when I think of his goodness that the Lord has done towards me, I will give him praise. Listen to me, this is not the time to think about what the devil has taken away from you. It's the time to think of what God is doing. Think of what God has said. The prophetic destiny is tied to the word. The word that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. The word of God. That's why the Bible says that we should not take counsel from the ungodly, nor sit with the sinners, nor the scornful. But our delight must be upon the law, and upon the word of God do we meditate day and night. So that whatever we do will prosper. So that we'll be like that tree planted by the rivers of water. Anything we do will prosper. Every source that men close against us, many sources of blessings open to us. Can I hear you clap off into Jesus? But many of us are flowing with the time. Like what we call it in our days, hustling. Hustling with the time. Hustling. Anything you see, you put your hands. No. You have a prophetic destiny. You have a prophetic destiny. Go into prayer with the word of God. Prophesy into your life. When Elisha got to the river that was open for Elijah to pass, and the river closed back, Elisha got there. He shouted, where is the Lord God of Elisha? Talabro shikadabo. If this river was opened by the prophetic, it will open again by the prophetic. I decree, if God can bless a man, he can bless you. I didn't hear your amen. Go into prayer with your prophetic word. Find out the prophetic mandate of your life. Find out what God has said about you. Find out what God has done about you. Don't just leave your life to chance. If somebody hear me, say, I hear you. Don't leave your life to chance. When children were in the womb of Rebecca, The Bible said Rebecca was so worried and troubled. What is going on? What's happening inside me? In the book of Genesis 25, verse 22, Rebecca went and inquired of God and sought, what is going on in my life? And she said, if it be so, toss. And she went and inquired of the Lord. And verse 23, the Bible said there, and the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb, and two manner of people shall be what? Separated from what? Thy bones. And one shall be what? Shall be stronger than what? The other people. And the elder shall serve the younger. Rebecca heard that prophecy. She knew what God told her. So when the time came for the prophetic blessing, she said, my husband did not hear this, but I heard it. She positioned Jacob. One shall be stronger than the other. There was a prophetic destiny in the life of Jacob. But Jacob needed to sit down and contend for his destiny. He went through it in the way he knew. He went through it by tricks. But one day he was left alone where he wrestled with an angel and contended for his destiny. His name was changed from Jacob to Israel, and his life began to flow. If he never wrestled with an angel, if he never contended for his destiny, he will answer Jacob all his life. But it came to a time where his name was changed from Jacob to what? Israel. Why was it to Israel? Israel was the original name God has given him. But by all forms of proclamation, the father called him Jacob. And if you read the scripture, the Bible says the father loved Esau, but the mother loved who? Jacob. But God gave him a name that nobody had. The father never called him Jacob. The father never called him Israel. It was the prophetic destiny that gave him his name. Stretch your hands here. There's somebody hearing my voice. Your prophetic destiny is about to manifest. It will disallow everything the devil is humiliating you with. It will stop the mouth of darkness, because you have been predestinated not to be conformed to this world, but to come into conformity with the word of God that has been spoken in the name of Jesus Christ. Can I hear an amen? That's why the book of Colossians chapter 2 from verse number 13 said, after forgiving us our sins and trespass and cleansing us, hallelujah, you being dead in your sins and the circumcision of your heart, had he quickened together with him, having forgiven you all your trespasses. Verse number 14, he said, blotting out the handwriting of ordinances that was against us, which was contrary to us, took it out of the way and nailing it to the cross. Ladies and gentlemen, Jesus took away every handwriting of ordinance, contrary, whatever predictions before you were born, prophesied into your DNA, spoken into your life. This is the time to rise up, contend. I don't know where your mother went. I don't know what your grandmother said. I don't know the covenants and deities that were, they have prophesied against your family. There is what you call household bondage, the house of bondage. I don't know where you come from. Maybe nobody rises, nobody progresses. Maybe everybody thinks it's by their effort. I have seen many Christians think their success is in their effort. No, it is by your prophetic destiny. By your prophetic destiny. Hannah will have been an underdog barren woman. But she said, among all the barren women here, Father, I want you to use my womb and produce yourself a prophet. She hit into the prophetic realm and she engaged a covenant. Covenant provokes prophecy. And the man of God thought she was drunk. But when she told the man of God, sorry, sir, with humility, I am not drunk. I am engaging in this prophecy. The man of God turned to her and said, this time next year, you shall embrace the child. Hannah, the barren woman, had not only Samuel, had five other children. She became a prophetic agenda in her time. Even those who were fruitful didn't have as much as she had. Give God a hand of praise. We must understand that we need to war. Paul said to Timothy, go into warfare. Make a good warfare with the prophecies that have gone ahead of you. Some of us don't write down when we come to church the prophecy we receive. We come to church like men going to farm without cutlass. We just hear the word and go. We don't go into prayers with what we write down. Why do you write down in church? So that you go into prayers with them. so that you make declarations with them, so that you stand in the gap for your children, for your household, and begin to buy prophecy, begin to buy prophecy, begin to buy prophecy. Change the aura, change the covenant, change all the circumstance that happened in the day. The Bible said battle were becoming too tough. Joshua looked up and prophesied to the sun, say, sun, stand still. O ye moon, stand still until I win this battle. Prophecy kept moon hanging, kept sun hanging, until victory came to the side of the righteous. Who says we have no prophetic destiny? I decree you have a prophetic destiny. What is a prophetic destiny? A supernaturally orchestrated destiny. Jeremiah, you are ordained to be prophet to nations. Today I'm speaking about Jeremiah. He will have lived an ordinary life. David engaged Goliath by prophetic destiny. I come against you in the name of the Lord God whom you defy the army. I am the one. He put himself in the realm of the prophetic, and the enemy could not stand him. Open my eyes and lighten my eyes. Daniel understood by books in the book of Daniel chapter 9 from verse 1 to 4. He understood by books that the time of captivity, 700 years, was over. And the Bible said in verse 2, he engaged his heart. Daniel understood by books, can I hear an amen, that the numbers of the years whereof the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah the prophet, that he will accomplish 70 years in the desolation of Jerusalem. And Daniel said, yes, 70 years is over. This course must go. And the Bible says in verse 3, he set his face unto the Lord God to seek by prayer and by supplication and by fasting and by sackcloth and by ash. He engaged battle realm in the spirit. Listen to me. There are times for you to leave all this struggle. You have all struggled and struggled. Your effort is eating no. Connection is giving you no nothing. It's just giving you piecemeal. Engage the prophetic. Engage the prophetic. The Bible says he sought the Lord. He sought the Lord. And I prayed unto the Lord my God and made my confessions and said, oh Lord, thou great and dreadful God, keeping covenant and mercy unto them that love thee and to them that keep thy commandment. And the Bible said he spoke to God. The time for our prophecy to come, our liberation to come, our freedom to come, this is the time. This is the time. Can I hear you stand, declare, and say, this is my time? As you said it now, all the limitations have just fallen. Barriers have just been broken. Give your hand and shout a big amen. Be seated. Daniel made that declaration. Prayer set our face before God. When you set your face to God, your destiny, every enemy of your destiny will bow to you. When you set your face to God, the enemy, the one walking behind the scene, will be neutralized, paralyzed, will be humiliated. Am I communicating? The wicked one must be stopped. Can I hear you shout? The wicked one must be stopped. I didn't hear your voice. Say with me, the wicked one. We all have loved ones, children, brothers, sisters, who the enemy has vowed to destroy. But hear me, child of God, don't give up in the prayer. Don't give up in the prayer. Just stay in the prayer. Sometimes it becomes so helpless. Sometimes you don't know what to say. Sometimes it looks humiliating. But hear me, the prophetic agenda of God is always the key factor in any man's life. Nothing, nothing, nothing can stop the prophetic from coming to pass in your life. Can I hear an amen? When you set your face to seek God, your destiny overpowers the will of the enemy. The wicked one is put to shame. If you hear me, say, I hear you. Are you hearing my voice? The wicked one is put to shame. Look at chapter 20 of that verse 9. Daniel chapter 9, verse 20. Glory to God. Glory to God. Verse 20. And whilst I was speaking and praying and confessing my sins and the sins of the people of Israel and presenting my supplication before the Lord my God for the holy, what, mountains of my God. Verse 20, 21. And whilst I was what? Speaking and praying, even the man, Gabriel. Who is Gabriel? The archangel. Who is Gabriel? The archangel. Whom I had seen in the vision at the beginning, began what? Causing to fly swiftly, touched me about the time of the evening obligation. My labor of Kotosa. Look at verse 22. Hallelujah. And he informed me and talked with me and said, "Oh Daniel, I am now come forth to give these keys and understand them." Come on, stretch your hand. Say, "I receive." Somebody say, "I have now come to give you what?" Receive it in the name of Jesus. When you contend for your destiny, there are certain things you will find in your life you've not seen before. There are certain things that will enter. The Bible said the angel touched me. When he touched me, he said unto me, everybody say with me, he said unto me, "I have come forth to give you what? Skills and understanding." I have come to give you skills and understanding. I have come to make a deposit inside you. What you were not born with, I have come to a deposit. What you have not found before in your life, I have come to drop. Am I communicating here? Somebody hearing my voice, some skills are dropping right now. Some understanding are dropping right now. Very soon, people will shout, "Wow," because of your life. Something you've never known, an idea you've never seen, a skill you've never been able to encounter. The Bible says, "I have come." And the Bible says he came with speed and swiftness. He said, "I have come to give you skill and understanding." Why skills? To be able to do what others cannot. Why understanding? Wisdom that nobody has been able to fathom. I see you breaking into a realm of impossibility. I see you coming out with solution. I see you breaking the era of limitations. Everything that have stood against men in your DNA, I see you crossing the lines. I didn't hear your shout of amen. I say I see you crossing the lines. I see you breaking the limits. I see you taking over. I have come to give you. But hear me, because you should not cease in prayer, the enemy will give you those things. But hear me, the enemy will give you all sorts of barriers, but heaven will give you the skill to overcome them. Why do you need skills? You need technical or technology. There is somebody hearing my voice. You are about to break into a realm of technology that the whole world will stand still for your sake. You didn't hear me, you will shout your amen like thunder. A technology coming into your life that when you come out, you will stand out. The nations will come to you and seek the wisdom that God has given you. Why am I giving you those skills? Because there's something that God is doing in your life. Daniel chapter 10 verse 12. Why? Daniel 10 verse 12. The Bible said, "Further again, then said he unto me, Fear not, Daniel, for from the first day that thou didst what? Set thy heart to understand and to what? Chasten thyself before thy God. Thy words were heard, and I am come down for thy word." Somebody say, "Thy words were heard, and I have come down for thy word." Thy words were heard, and I have come down for thy word. Who tell you that heavens are not hearing your prayers? You are praying and you think heaven is not hearing you. You are praying and you think nobody is hearing you. Heaven is hearing your prayer. The words you have spoken to heaven, they are coming down with testimony. From the first day, your words were heard. Ladies and gentlemen, listen to me. Sometimes when we pray, we see things go helpless. Sometimes we pray, we see things go worst. Sometimes we pray, we don't know what is going on. But let me tell you, heaven has heard you. Very soon you are going to be dancing, you are going to be testifying, you are going to be jubilating. Keep your prayers going. Oh, if you hear me, shall I hear you? Keep your prayers going. He says, "I am come down with thy words." Verse 13, the Bible says, glory to God, "But the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 120 days. But lo, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me. And I remained there with the king of Persia I remained there with the kings of Persia. Now listen to me. If you look at verse 1 of Daniel chapter 1, of Daniel chapter 9, it described Darius, a physical king that was ruling. Look at Daniel chapter 9 verse 1. In the first year of who? Darius what? The king of what? Of the seed of Media. Now, look now to this verse we just read. Another king, that is a physical king and that is a spiritual king in the same land and in the same territory. The Bible reveals that Daniel prayed this prayer in this time, but the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me. What prince? Demonic prince, principality. But there was a physical king. Am I communicating? There was a physical king on the earth, and there is another one in the heavens. And I decree, as you pray and intercede, every spiritual powers on the earth or the spiritual powers in the heavens, they will quake and give up your testimony. I didn't hear you shout amen. Now hear me. He did not say Darius, the king, resisted him. For Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, it was the physical king, the Nebuchadnezzar, that was resisting them. Am I communicating? We did not see the what? We know that the spiritual was there because he made a god to represent himself. But listen to me. Here, the Bible talked, in this time, there was a king called Darius. But hear me. In this Daniel chapter 10 verse 13, and the prince of the ruler of darkness was the one that heard the prayer. But hear me. Because Daniel did not cease to pray. Daniel kept praying. Am I communicating? Even though that angel was withheld, another stronger angel came to rescue. But hear me, child of God. We are in the generation of the blood of Jesus. No devil can stand the blood. Oh, come on. Can I hear somebody shout a big amen? I say, no devil can stand the blood. Come on, lift your voice. Say, no devil. And so when your prayers are coming, the pathways of the earth opens, the pathways of the spirit realm opens. No devil can withstand you, because the spiritual and the physical all have been brought under the dominion of Christ. Why he shed his blood on the cross is to defeat the principality and to defeat the human powers. So every conspiracy of leaders on earth to humiliate your destiny, you shall bypass it. You shall bypass it. You will bypass it. Every conspiracy of rulers of darkness and wickedness in high places to hinder your life, business, career, you will overcome it. I didn't hear your amen. But you must seek the face of God. You must contend for your prophetic destiny. What was Daniel contending for? His prophetic destiny. The prince of the kingdom of Persia. There were two powers, two forces, one physical king, the other spiritual king, but they all bow. Give God a hand of praise. They all bow. I see somebody receiving grace to overcome all this challenge. Daniel stayed in the place of prayer. Daniel stayed in the place of prayer. We need to contend for our destiny. Why? When you are praying, weakness will come, frustration will come. But as long as you stay in that prayer, the Bible says in the same Daniel chapter 10 verse 18, Daniel 10 verse 18, Daniel was praying and then came again and touched me, one like the what? Appearance of a man, and he strengthened me. Can I hear an amen? Why Daniel kept praying? Another angel came and touched him, one like what? The appearance of what? A man. And he strengthened me, because the kind of strength you need in the spirit realm is different from the physical strength. In the days of Daniel, angel has to touch you for strength to come. But in our days of Christ, the Holy Ghost will be the one to strengthen you. Oh, come on, shout, Holy Ghost! The Holy Ghost will strengthen you. Say, and that angel touched me and strengthened me. Go down verse 19. Glory to God. And said, oh man, greatly beloved, fear not. Peace be unto thee. Be strong. Yea, be strong. And when he had spoken unto me, I was strengthened and said, let my Lord speak, for thou hast strengthened me. Thou hast what? Strengthened me. Thou hast what? Strengthened me. Ladies and gentlemen, when you engage to seek God concerning your child, your house that is remaining uncompleted, your situation, your matter, don't give up. The thing may go worse. Don't give up. Stay in the place of prayer. Your business may, don't be jumping up and down. Don't let men deceive you. No man can do what God has not done. Stay in your prayers. Get spiritual strength. And he strengthened me and said unto me. And I said, okay, now speak. I have been strengthened. Look at verse 20. Can I hear an amen? God, he said, then said he, knowest thou whereof I come unto thee? And now I will return to fight with what? The prince of Persia. And when I am gone forth, lo, the prince of who? Glacia shall come. I will fight the prince. Lift your hands this day. Every prince of darkness harassing you, God will fight for you. Ooh, God will fight for you. Now listen to me. Angels don't fight for those with no strength. The Bible says when the day of delivery, when a woman cannot push forth, there is no strength. You say, no, there's a day of sorrow. You must carry strength. That's why women, when it's their day of delivery, they prepare for it. They eat better food. They wait because you need strength to push out that baby. Am I communicating with you? You need strength. There's no chewing gum. If you are weak, it's going to be a problem. You need physical strength. No pregnant woman allows sickness, malaria, anything around. You make sure 3-4 months to your time of delivery, you are free from all those nonsense. Stay free from all those things so that you are physically and spiritually strong because you are about to bring forth. Any child of God has sensed your breakthrough. Stop all these useless, stupid distractions. People coming to tempt you. Joseph was at the time of his breakthrough, and his master's wife thought it was naked woman body that will attract him. Come on, cover your nakedness, woman. I've not called out for this rubbish. I see destiny coming forth. I just finished praying and interceding. Ladies and gentlemen, temptations and all kinds of trials come against us to weaken us so that our angels will not function. But I decree and declare, your angels have come to strengthen you. Your prophetic destiny, listen, against medical instructions, declarations, known facts, your destiny by prophetic mandate overpass. The will of the enemy is broken. No man has power. The Bible says what God has prepared for them that love him, eyes have not seen, ears have not heard. There's somebody getting an unusual breakthrough. I sense it coming to you. Your enlargement has come. Your breakthrough has come. Skills, knowledge,